Chapter 8 deals with cellular reproduction, and there are a variety of components to this, and the first one of these that we really need to figure out is the cell cycle. And so let's make sure we understand, first of all, what reproduction actually achieves. I mean, what exactly do we do here? Well, one of the things we need to do is produce new cells, and in order to produce new cells, we take existing cells and we divide them. That's pretty straightforward. The second thing that reproduction achieves, and that's also critical, is the creation of the next generation. And that's, of course, fundamentally different, because when we talk about producing new cells, that's something that happens within the body. And when we look at the next generation, that is something that happens away from our body. This is something that happens in the next generation. So both of these are very important, and cell division is very important as part of this. Now, when we look at cell division in general, we'll find that cells need to divide so that all those cells that are aging or lost can be replaced. Think about how you lose cells. Every time you eat something, there are some of the cells in your mouth that get scraped off by the food. When you swallow, there are some of the cells that are being rubbed off by the food as it goes down. And so there are a variety of ways by which cells are lost all the time. Every time you go to sleep at night, a whole bunch of cells are going to be lost to your bedding just because they're aging, they are dying, and they'll be lost. Now, the production of additional cells is going to also allow growth and, of course, reproduction. So if you're wanting to grow an area in the body, which is, of course, critical during development, or when you're trying to produce cells that are going to be used in reproduction, those are additional cells, not just reproducing old ones. Cell division is called mitosis, and mitosis is what this first part of the lecture will deal with. Now, when you look at cell division just as an example, you'll see here there's a human kidney cell, and this kidney cell is dividing. And where you had one cell, you end up with two cells. Now, cell replacement in that sense may be that the one cell that's dividing was aging, and the two new cells are the rejuvenated versions of that cell. Of course, you can also have growth. And so in the image on the right, you see that there is growth in cell division, and shown there is an early human embryo. So clearly, cellular division is going to be important there. When it comes to creating the next generation, there are also some very important functions of cell division. There are two types of reproduction, it turns out, asexual or non-sexual, and sexual reproduction. And those two are fundamentally different. During asexual reproduction, there's no exchange of genetic material. That means whatever genetic material the organism has is the same as what the offspring will have. There's no influx of any new material. And so basically, what you do is you make an exact copy of yourself. This is something that has been discussed in the past. You've probably heard about this. This is what cloning is all about. When you start with one organism and you don't add anything, you just make a new organism out of the old organism. There are a lot of unicellular organisms that reproduce via asexual reproduction, but there are also some that we know quite well. For example, if you look at your strawberry plants, strawberry plants end up sending out runners. And these runners, here's your first strawberry plant, they send out runners and they take root and they form another strawberry plant. And this is the mother plant, this is the daughter plant, and it's asexual reproduction. You also see this with various grasses, but there's other organisms. There are lizards that also go through asexual reproductions, or frogs. Now, sexual reproduction is fundamentally different because you need two organisms in the process. In sexual reproduction, two organisms exchange genetic material, And the product of this is a new generation of organisms that looks very similar, but is not genetically identical. Now, the way this works is you take usually an egg cell and a sperm cell, and the egg cell and the sperm cell meet. They fuse. This fusion is called fertilization, and you end up with a new single cell, and that's the start of the next generation. There are also some organisms by which DNA can directly be injected from one organism to another, and that is also a possibility. Now, the process, in order to do this, you need reproductive tissues that prepare those special egg and sperm cells. Those are collectively known as gametes, and gametes are produced by reproductive tissues. The process by which we produce gametes is called meiosis, and that is what we're going to talk about in the last parts of this lecture. Now, because of all the genetic information that is contained in a cell, one of the things that's critical is to figure out what exactly happens to this genetic information. Now, each cell has all the genetic information, not only that it needs, but also that the entire organism needs. Now, depending on what kind of cell it is, perhaps not all of this information is turned on in all cells all the time, but it's still there. It resides in each cell. So each cell contains the entire genome that makes up you. Now, most of this, specifically, is located in the nucleus inside of eukaryotic cells. So when we look at what happens to the cell and to the genetic material, that is one of the key places to look. Now, what do cells do in general? Well, they do two things, really. They conduct their metabolic activities. That is one thing. It's sort of the business of the cell needs to be conducted. And then they divide. The metabolic phase, when the cell does the business of the cell, is called interphase. And inter is related here to an in-between stage. So in this case, inter is kind of saying it's in between. It's the in-between phase. Well, in between what? It's in between two reproductive phases. The one reproductive phase that produces the cell is followed by another reproductive phase that produces more cells, and the period between those is called interphase. The reproductive phase itself is what we call mitosis. Now, the best way to illustrate this is using a diagram. And this diagram is the cell cycle diagram. And if we start with a cell cycle diagram, let's identify two important components of the cell cycle. First of all, the interphase, which is where all the metabolic activities take place in the cell. And really, that takes place, or that takes up about 90% of the cell's life, whereas the mitotic phase takes up about 10%. Now, in this diagram, it doesn't look as if it's 90-10, but because of all the different things they had to draw in here, that's why it looks a little bit skewed. Now, let's start with one of these cells, and this cell has just been produced. So this is a new cell. And this new cell needs to start growing. It needs to start the metabolic phase. It needs to produce a variety of things. And so one of the things we can say is that this first part of a cell's life is the initial growth phase. And so this initial growth phase gets all the necessary things that a cell needs going. It allows the cell to metabolize. It allows it to bring in some nutrients. It allows it to produce a certain number of proteins in order for it to do all the tasks that are needed. And once it gets to a certain stage, in this case, the stage is indicated by the next drawing here. So this is where the new stage starts. We have something called the S phase. And the S actually stands for synthesis. During the S phase, the DNA duplicates. Now, in this S phase, in this synthesis phase, the cell doesn't do many other things. It is very much involved in the process of duplicating the genetic material. Now, eventually, this genetic material is duplicated. And so what you can see here is you start with a chromosome here. This is a chromosome. And now this is a chromosome, but as you can see, it has one, two copies of the genetic material. So it has actually been copying this genetic material in order to make two batches of it. Now, once it has done this, there is a secondary growth phase, the G2 phase. And that allows the cell, once again, to accumulate all the nutrients it needs to move forward and really get into the last phase of its life cycle, and that is the mitotic phase. Mitosis is the division of the nucleus. And so what happens in this last part of the cell's life cycle, as you can see, the genetic material is actually divided, and you have some of it going to this cell and some of it going to that cell, and that's what happens during mitosis. And lastly, when all the genetic material is divided, then the cell itself divides, and that's called cytokinesis. So a lot of things happen during the life cycle of a cell. This is a much simplified diagram to give you a basic understanding of what needs to happen. But that's the cell cycle for our instance.